like Dora, I'd like us all to consider the donor who gave Dean his new heart. And as I was preparing to come here, I asked Dean if he had any new poems that he wanted to share, and he said that he did. So here's one envisioning who that donor might have been. It's called Harvest. Bring me the high heart of a trapezist. If not, bring me the heart of a drunk monk, so I may illuminate an ancient text in a language I can't understand. The brain, too, is blood. Blood racing 100 miles an hour on training wheels. So let me splash through a red puddle. Let me kiss the face of a red puddle. Let me write my crazed, extreme demands on the frost-cracked window of God's split chest, on the wind-fussed trees and people outside, analytically plummeting. Bring me the zigzag heart of a plummeting angel, straight from the bus crash. Bring me a cup straight from the cauldron, then suture me up. The sailboat shadow of a sundial sweeps us all aside. Common song made your own with a penny whistle. Now, bring me the heart of a panther, boiled in the delirium of an open wound, smelling of black sugars. Then bring me whatever leftover twigs from the pyre, so I may make a resting place deep in the bright shining thicket. Mm-hmm. And I'm happy to report that he is writing a lot. And again, right before I came here, I got a sheaf of beautiful new poems from Dee. I have to say I was an admiring fan and reader of Dean before, long before he sent me the manuscript for his most recent book, Fall Higher. But you know, as an editor, I tend to always have my bullshit detector turned to high, and I was waiting to be impressed. And not only did I discover or rediscover a nimble and generous imagination in the new poems, I realized that what we have in Dean is, as many here have suggested, a great love poet. And his poems are infused with a search for the beloved in all things, and in each of us, if you will. So again, I think that it's increasingly pronounced in the new poems, but I realize that it's always been there in his work. And personally, I feel that the sense of wonder that he has in the new poems has given me a reinvigorated life of poetry, a second chance, if you will, the same way that the donor gave Dean a second chance. He's made it new. Just as that donor has given Dean a new heart and a second chance, I think Dean has given all of us a second chance. I have to say also that throughout all this period that I've been working on the book with him, I've had the great fortune of working with his wife, Lori, and who helped shepherd this book and his forthcoming book, which is going to be a new and selected, called Bender, into the lives of readers. During his worst health conditions, she was always there, and in doing so, she gave me a second chance to consider Dean's work. I was coming home late one evening, the night I think that the reading was going on in Austin, and got the message that he was in surgery, they had found a heart. And then a couple days later, I got the message from Lori saying that she had listened to his heart for the first time, and it sounded like an ecstatic monkey jumping on a very tight drum. I just want to say that Lori is very much a part of the poems that Dean has been writing in this most recent book, and the ones that have been coming since the book. And so I'm going to say one of them that I really love, called Delphiniums in a Window Box. Every sunrise, sometimes strangers' eyes, not necessarily swans, even crows, even the evening fusillade of bats, that place where the creek goes underground. How many weeks before I see you again? Stacks of books, every page, characters' rage and poets' strange contraption of syntax and song, every song, even when there isn't one, every thistle, splinter, butterfly over the drainage ditches, every stray. Did you see the meteor shower? Every question, conversation, even with almost nothing, cricket, cloud. Because of you, I'm talking to crickets, clouds, confiding in a cat. Everyone says, come to your senses, and I do, of you. Every touch, electric, every taste, you. Every smell, even a burning sugar. Every cry and laugh. Toothpick samples at the farmer's market, melon, plum, I come undone, undone. Mm-hmm.